Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. This is lecture number 10.4. The topic is Problem Solving in Dimensional Analysis. In the earlier lectures, we discussed the theory part of dimensional analysis and we solved one set of problem in the earlier lecture. And in this lecture also, we continue with the problem solving and the learning outcome to the students. At the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the dimensional analysis. Example number 4, derive on the basis of dimensional analysis suitable parameter to present the thrust developed by a propeller. Assume that the thrust P depends on angular velocity omega, speed of advance V, diameters D, dynamic viscosity mu, mass density rho and elasticity of the fluid medium, which can be denoted by the speed of the sound in the medium C. And this is from November 2012 question paper. The solution to the problem, the thrust P depends on angular velocity omega, speed of advance V, diameter D, dynamic viscosity mu, mass density rho, elasticity of the fluid medium C. So, we write the relationship. P, the thrust P is a function of, phi is a function of omega, V, D, mu, rho and C. We write in another way, a function of all the variables. So, the P is the thrust is the dependent variable. All the other 6 variables are independent variable. Now, we combine them. So, F is a function of power, angular velocity, velocity, diameter, kinematic absolute viscosity, density and speed of the elasticity of fluid medium, that is equal to 0. Now, here there are 7 numbers of variable, number of variables equal to 7, number of repeating variable equal to 3. So, the repeating variable in the set of parameter available here, we have 3 different types of properties, geometrical properties, fluid properties and flow properties. So, among the 7 variables available, we have to identify 1 geometrical property, 1 fluid property and 1 flow property as a repeating variable. So, out of 7, there are 3 repeating variables and there will be 4 non-repeating variables. So, the pi terms are written in terms of the non-repeating variables. So, all the repeating variables will be available in all the 5 terms. Then there will be 1 non-repeating variable. So, the number of 5 terms equal to n minus m, 7 minus 3 equal to 4. And these are all the repeating variables. So, we identify geometric property diameter, flow property velocity, fluid property density. So, the 5 terms are, so you look at all the 4, 5 terms, phi 1, d to the power a 1, v to the power b 1, rho to the power c 1 and p. So, this is P, omega, mu and C, they are the non-repeating variables. D, V, rho are the repeating variables. Then, phi 2 equal to D to the power A 2, V to the power B 2, rho to the power C 2 and omega. Phi 3 equal to D to the power A 3, V to the power B 3, rho to the power C 3 and mu. Phi 4 equal to D to the power A 4, V to the power B 4, rho to the power C 4 and C. Now, here using the dimensional homogeneity, using the dimensions of different parameters, we have to find out the constants or the coefficients A1 to C4. Then we have to substitute here and find the 5 terms. The 5 terms are non-dimensional. Phi 1, phi 2, phi 3, phi 4 are they are non-dimensional parameter. The dimensions of different parameters involved in the problem. The thrust P, the unit is Newton, M, L, T to the power minus 2. Diameter D, in the unit is meter, dimension is L. Velocity V, the unit is meters per second. And dimension is L T to the power minus 1. Density rho, the unit is kilogram per meter cube and the dimension is ML to the power minus 3. Angular velocity omega, the speed RPM is the unit, T to the power minus 1. Viscosity mu, Newton second by meter square, ML to the power minus 1, T to the power minus 1. Elasticity of the fluid C, meters per second, L T to the power minus 1. Now, substituting the dimensions in the 5 terms, phi 1 equal to d a to the power d to the power a 1, v to the power b 1, rho to the power c 1 into p. Substituting the dimensions, left hand side non-dimensional parameter m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0. right hand side l to the power a1, l t to the power minus 1 to the power b1, m l to the power minus 3 to the power c1, and the unit for p power thrust m l t to the power minus 2. So, comparing the powers of m l t on both sides, for m 0 equal to c plus 1, so c1 plus 1, so c1 equal to 1. For L, A1 plus B1 minus 3C1 plus 1 equal to 0. For T, 0 equal to minus B1 minus 2. So, B1 equal to 2. B1 equal to minus 2. C1 equal to minus 1. And substituting in the A1 term, so A1 equal to minus 2. So, A1 minus 2, B1 minus 2, C1 minus 1. Now, you substitute here in the phi term. So, phi equal to, phi 1 equal to D to the power A1, V to the power B1, rho to the power C1 into P. So, phi 1 equal to d to the power minus 2, v to the power minus 2, rho to the power minus 1 into p. So, r phi 1 equal to p divided by rho v square d square into v square. This is the phi 1 terms. Then, phi 2 term. So, phi 2 equal to d to the power a2, v to the power b2, rho to the power c2 into omega. So, substitute the dimensions m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0 equal to l a to the power 2 into L T to the power minus 1 to the power B2, M L to the power minus 3 to the power C2, and omega T to the power minus 1. Comparing the powers of M L T on both sides, for M 0 equal to C2, so C2 equal to 0. For L 0 equal to A2 plus B2 minus 3 C2. T 0 equal to minus B2 minus 1, so B2 equal to minus 1. So, substituting in the equation, we will get A2 equal to 1. So, here A2 equal to 1, B2 equal to minus 1 and C2 equal to 0. Now, the pi 2 term. So, pi 2 equal to dA2, d to the power A2, V to the power B2, rho to the power C2 into omega. So, pi 2 equal to d to the power A2 equal to 1, B2 equal to minus 1 and C2 equal to 0 into omega. So, pi 2 equal to omega d by V. That is the pi 2 term. Then, pi 3. So, pi 3 equal to d to the, pi 3 equal to d to the power A3, V to the power B3, rho to the power C3 into mu. So, substituting the dimensions, M to the power 0, L to the power 0, T to the power 0 equal to L to the power A3, L T to the power minus 1 to the power B3, M L to the power minus 3 to the power C3 into ML to the power minus 1, T to the power minus 1. So, comparing the powers of MLT on both sides, for M, 0 equal to C3 plus 1. For L, 0 equal to A3 plus B3 minus 3 C3 minus 1. T, 0 equal to minus B3 minus 1. So, from the equation, minus B3. So, B3 equal to minus 1, C3 equal to minus 1, A3 equal to minus 1. So, A3, B3, C3, both all the values are minus 1. Now, in the pi 3 term, pi 3 equal to D to the power A3, V to the power B3, rho to the power C3 into mu. So, pi 3 equal to d to the power minus 1, b to the power minus 1, rho to the power minus 1 into mu. So, pi 3 equal to mu by rho d v. Then, pi 4 term. So, pi 4 equal to d to the power a4, v to the power b4, rho to the power c4 into c. So, substitute the dimensions m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0 equal to l to the power a4, l t power minus 1 to the power b4, m l to the power minus 3 to the power c4, into L T to the power minus 1. So, comparing the powers of M L T on both sides. So, M U, M for M, C equal to 0 equal to C4. And for L, 0 equal to A4 plus B4 minus C, minus 3 C4 plus 1. For T, 0 equal to minus B4 minus 1. So, from here, C4 equal to 0, B4 equal to minus 1 and A4 equal to 0. Now, substituting in the equation, pi 4 equal to d to the power a4, v to the power b4, rho to the power c4 into c. So, here substituting pi 4 equal to d to the power 0, v to the power minus 1, rho to the power 0 into c. So, pi 4 equal to c by v. Now, the functional relationship. So, pi 1 equal to a function of pi 2, pi 3, pi 4. Substituting the pi terms, p by rho d square v square equal to a function of omega d by v, comma mu by rho d v, comma c by v. So, finally, the thrust p equal to rho d v square into a function of omega d by v, comma mu by rho d v, comma c by v. So, this is the answer to the problem. Example number 5, the dimensional, the frictional torque t of a disc of diameter d rotating at a speed n in a fluid of viscosity mu and density rho in a turbulent flow is given by T equal to d square n square rho into phi of mu by d square n by n rho. Prove that by the method of dimensions using the Buckingham pi theorem. So, this is from May 2013 question paper. So, the solution to the problem, the frictional torque T depends on the diameter, speed and fluid viscosity density. So, T is a function of d diameter, n speed, mu and rho. So, we rewrite as a function of T comma d comma n comma mu comma rho equal to 0. So, there are 5 variables and the number of repeating variables are 3. So, we identify one geometrical property, one fluid property and one flow property. So, the number of pi terms n minus m equal to 5 minus 3 equal to 2. So, repeating variables are geometric property, we take diameter, fluid property, we take density, flow property, we take the speed. Therefore, the pi terms, pi 1 equal to d to the power a 1, n to the power b 1, rho to the power c 1 into t. Pi 2 equal to d to the power a 2, n to the power b 2, rho to the power c 2 into mu. So, the dimensions of various parameters in the problem, torque T equal to Newton meter, unit is Newton meter, dimension is m L square T to the power minus 2, diameter D, unit is m, dimension is L, speed n, unit is rpm, dimension is T to the power minus 1, density rho, the unit is kilogram per meter cube and the dimension is m L to the power minus 3, viscosity mu, the unit is Newton second by meter square, the dimension is m L to the power minus 1, T to the power minus 1. So, substituting in the pi terms, substituting the dimensions in the pi terms, pi 1 term, pi 1 equal to d to the power a 1, n to the power b 1, rho to the power c 1 into t. Substituting the dimensions, m to the power 0, l to the power 0, 2 to the power 0 equal to l to the power a 1, t to the power minus 1 to the power b 1, m l to the power minus 3 to the power c 1, m l square t to the power minus 2. So, comparing the powers of mlt on both sides. For m 0 equal to c1 plus 2 c1 plus 1, for l 0 equal to a1 minus 3 c1 plus 2, for t 0 equal to minus b1 minus 2. So, solving c1 equal to minus 1, b1 equal to minus 2, a1 equal to minus 5. Now, substituting the coefficients on the pi term, so we will get pi1 equal to d to the power a1, n to the power b1, rho to the power c1 into t. So, pi1 equal to d to the power minus 5, n to the power minus 2, rho to the power minus 1 into t, or pi 1 equal to t by d to the power 5 n square into rho. Then pi 2 term, so pi 2 equal to d to the power a 2, n to the power b 2, rho to the power c 2 into mu. So, substitute the dimensions, m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0 equal to l to the power a 2, t to the power minus 1 to the power b 2, m l to the power minus 3 to the power c 2, and m l to the power minus 1 t to the power minus 1. So, comparing the powers of mlt on both sides, for m 0 equal to c2 plus 1, for l 0 equal to a2 minus 3 c2 minus 1, for t 0 equal to minus b2 minus 1. So, b2 equal to minus 1, c2 equal to minus 1 and a2 equal to minus 2. So, substituting in the pi term, so pi2 equal to d to the power a2, n to the power b2, rho to the power c2 into mu. So, pi 2 equal to d to the power minus 2, n to the power minus 1, rho to the power minus 1 into mu. So, the pi 2 equal to mu by d square n rho, n into rho. So, the functional relationship, pi 1 equal to a function of pi 2. So, t by d square n square rho equal to a phi function of mu by d square n rho. So, finally, torque t equal to d to the power 5 n square rho into a function of mu by d square n into rho. Example number 6. Using Buckingham pi theorem, show that the velocity through a circular orifice is given by v equal to square root of 2gh into a function of d by h into mu by rho vh, where h is the head causing the flow, d is the diameter of the orifice, mu is the coefficient of viscosity, rho is the mass density and g is acceleration due to gravity. So, this is from November 2013 question paper. The solution to the problem, the velocity through the circular orifice depends on head h, diameter of the orifice d, viscosity mu, density rho, acceleration due to gravity g. So velocity v is a function of h, comma d, comma mu, comma rho, comma g. So we rewrite the equation in terms of a function of velocity, head, diameter, viscosity, density, acceleration due to gravity equal to 0. So there are number of variables n equal to 6. So there are 6 variables, both dependent and independent variable. Number of repeating variable equal to 3. So we take one geometric property, one fluid property and one flow property. Number of pi terms are n minus m equal to 6 minus 3 equal to 3. So the repeating variables are, the geometric property is h, fluid property is rho and flow property is g. So we write the pi terms, pi 1 equal to h to the power a 1, rho to the power b 1, g to the power c 1 into v, pi 2 equal to h to the power a 2, rho to the power b 2, g to the power c 2 into d, and pi 3 equal to h to the power a 3, rho to the power b 3 and c, g to the power c 3 into mu. So the dimensions of various parameters here in the problem, velocity v, it is meters per second, l t to the power minus 1, head h, it is in meter, dimension is L. Diameter D, the unit is meter and dimension is L. Density rho, the unit is kilogram per meter cube and the dimension is ml to the power minus 3. Viscosity mu, the unit is newton second by meter square and dimension is ml to the power minus 1, t to the power minus 1. Acceleration due to gravity g, meter per second square, so L t to the power minus 2. Now substituting the pi dimensions in the pi term. Pi 1 term, pi 1 equal to h to the power a 1, rho to the power b 1, g to the power c 1 into v. Substitute the dimensions, m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0 equal to l to the power a 1, m l to the power minus 3 to the power b 1, l t to the power minus 2 to the power c 1 into l t to the power minus 1. So comparing the powers of mlt on both sides, so for m, 0 equal to b1, for L 0 equal to a1 minus 3b1 plus c1 plus 1, t 0 equal to minus 2c1 minus 1. So solving the equations, b1 equal to 0, a1 equal to minus 0.5 and c1 equal to minus 0.5. So substituting in the, substitute the coefficient in the pi term, so pi1 equal to h to the power a1, rho to the power b1, g to the power c1 into v. So pi 1 equal to h to the power minus 0.5, rho to the power 0 and g to the power minus 0.5 into v. So pi 1 equal to v by square root of gh. Then pi 2 term, pi 2 equal to h to the power a 2, rho to the power b 2, g to the power c 2 into d. So m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0 equal to l to the power a 2, m l to the power minus 3 to the power b 2, L t to the power minus 2 to the power c 2 into L. Now comparing the dimensions of both MLT, MLT on both sides. So for M, 0 equal to B2. For L, 0 equal to A2 minus 3B2 plus C2 minus plus 1. For T, 0 equal to minus 2C2. So C2 equal to 0, B2 equal to 0 and A2 equal to minus 1. Then substituting the coefficient in the pi term. So pi2 equal to h to the power a2, rho to the power b2, g to the power c2 into d. So substitute the coefficients, pi2 equal to h to the power minus 1, rho to the power 0, g to the power 0 into d. So pi2 equal to d by h. Then pi3 term. So for pi3 term, so pi3 equal to h to the power a3, rho to the power b3, g to the power c3 into mu. So substitute in the dimensions, m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0 equal to L to the power A3 into M L to the power minus 3 to the power B3, L T to the power minus 2 to the power C3 and M L to the power minus 1 T to the power minus 1. So comparing the powers of M L T on both sides. So for M, 0 equal to B3 plus 1. L equal to, for L, 0 equal to A3 minus 3 B3 plus C3 minus 1. For T, 0 equal to minus 2 C3 minus 1. So solving the equation, B3 equal to minus 1, C3 equal to minus 0.5, A3 equal to minus 1.5. Then substituting the coefficient in the pi term, so pi3 equal to h to the power A3, rho to the power B3, g to the power C3 into mu. So pi3 equal to h to the power minus 1.5, rho to the power minus 1, g to the power minus 0.5 into mu. So pi3 equal to mu by rho h into square root of gh. So substituting here, it will be pi to the pi 3 equal to mu by rho h into square root of gh. So this equal to mu by rho h into pi 1 by v. So because 1 by square root of gh equal to pi 1 divided by v. So combining mu divided by rho hv into pi 1. So pi 3 equal to mu divided by rho hv into pi 1. Now the functional relationship pi 1 equal to a function of pi 2 plus pi 3. So v by square root of gh equal to a function of d by h into comma mu by rho hv. So we can write v equal to square root of gh into a function of d by h comma mu by rho hv. And here we multiply by a constant 2. So v equal to square root of 2gh into a function of d by h comma mu by rho hv. So we understand that multiplying the any pi term by a constant 2 will not alter the value of the non-dimensional term. So it is a constant. It is dimensionless. So it will not alter the value of the pi term. Example number 7. The resistance R to the motion of a completely submerged body depends on length of the body L, velocity of the flow V, mass density of the fluid rho, kinematic viscosity gamma. Prove that by dimensional analysis R equal to rho L square V square into phi of VL by gamma. So this is from May 2009 question paper. The solution to the problem, resistance R depends on length L, velocity V, mass density rho and kinematic viscosity gamma. So, R is a function of L, V, rho and gamma. So, we write as a function F of R, L, V, rho, gamma equal to 0. The number of variables here, N equal to 5. Number of repeating variables, M equal to 3. So, number of pi terms are 2. N minus M equal to 5 minus 3 equal to 2. And the repeating variables are geometrical property L, fluid property rho and flow property V. So, these are all the properties taken. And there will be two pi terms. So, pi 1 equal to L to the power A1, rho to the power B1, V to the power C1 into R. Pi 2 equal to L to the power A2, rho to the power B2, V to the power C2 into gamma. So, the dimensions of different parameters in the problem. Resistance R, it is a force. Resistance is a force. Unit is Newton. Dimension is ML t to the power minus 2. Length L. The unit is meter. Dimension is L. Density rho, kilogram per meter cube, m L to the power minus 3. Velocity V, the unit is meters per second, L t to the power minus 1. Kinematic viscosity gamma, meter square per second, L square t to the power minus 1. So, substituting the dimensions in the pi terms, pi 1 term, pi 1 equal to L to the power A1, rho to the power B1, V to the power C1 into R. So, substituting the dimension, m to the power 0, L to the power 0, t to the power 0 equal to L to the power A1, into m L to the power minus 3 to the power B1, L t to the power minus 1 to the power C1, into m L t to the power minus 2. Now, comparing the powers of m L t on both sides, for m, 0 equal to B1 plus 1. For L, 0 equal to A1 minus 3 B1 plus C1 plus 1. For T, 0 equal to minus C1 minus 2. So, solving the equation, C1 equal to minus 2, B1 equal to minus 1. And substituting here for A1 equal to minus 2. So, pi 1 equal to L to the power A1, rho to the power B1, V to the power C1 into R. So, substituting the values of A1, B1, C1 here, pi 1 equal to L to the power minus 2, rho to the power minus 1, V to the power minus 2. That is equal into R. So, pi 1 equal to R by rho L square V square. Then pi 2 term. So, pi 2 equal to L to the power A2, rho to the power B2, V to the power C2 into gamma. So, substituting the dimensions, M to the power 0, L to the power 0, T to the power 0 equal to L to the power A2, M L to the power minus 3 to the power B2, L T to the power minus 1 to the power C2 into L square T to the power minus 1. So, comparing the powers of MLT in both sides, for M 0 equal to B2, for L 0 equal to A2 minus 3 B2 plus C2 plus 2, for T 0 equal to minus C2 minus 1. So, solving the equation, B2 equal to 0, C2 equal to minus 1 and A2 equal to minus 1. So, substituting in the pi term, pi 2 equal to L to the power A2, rho to the power B2, V to the power C2 into gamma. So, substituting the constants A2, B2, C2, then pi 2 equal to L to the power minus 1, rho to the power 0, V to the power minus 1 into gamma. So pi 2 equal to gamma by L into V. Then the functional relationship. So phi 1 equal to a function of phi 2 R by rho L square V square equal to a function of gamma by L V, or it is a function of V L by gamma. So taking the reciprocal of the value, that will not alter the dimension. So the final answer R equal to rho L square V square into a function of V L by gamma. So this is the answer to the problem. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find fluid mechanics and machinery. You refer to the book for additional problems in the dimensional analysis. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. Use the video lectures for your better preparation. And thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We will continue with the problem solving in the dimensional analysis in the next lecture also.